Starting today, you have to think of yourself as a brand. You do not belong to any company for life. You are not defined by your job title, and you're not confined by your job description. Hello and welcome to my channel. If today is the first time we're meeting, my name is Dennis. I'm an author, a public speaker, as well as a finance coach. So in this space, I discuss self-improvement as a topic. Today, I'm going to be talking about personal branding and why it is important that you have and develop one. But before I go into today's video, if this is your first time here, kindly subscribe to the channel. Also, remember to hit the notification icon so that YouTube lets you know each and every time I put up new content. And if in the process of watching this video, you find that it provides you with value, and give the video a thumbs up. So I'm talking about personal branding today. So without further ado, let's jump into the video. Most Kenyans celebrate the arrival of the weekend. I don't know about other countries, but Kenyans in particular are very happy about the arrival of the weekend. And this just goes to show you, most people are stuck in jobs they'd rather not be doing if some other options are viable. So they do these jobs to survive. So what then can you take away from this? Now more than ever, you should find something to do that you love doing. Related to this is the concept of delayed gratification. So you can find something that you love doing and that you know that if you put some time into it, then perhaps later on it can turn into some other source of revenue. I was reading a book last week called The Brand Called You. It's by an author called Tom Peters or something. In this book, he's talking about you as a brand, being the CEO of Me Inc. So what then is the meaning of personal branding? So personal branding is what people say about you when you're not in the room. It's establishing what you want to be known for, then allowing yourself to be known for it. Everything is branded, and big companies, big corporations understand this very well. Human beings like the concept of familiarity. They want to associate with something that is known. They want to associate with something that is loved and accepted by many people. You have to think of yourself in this way. You have to think of yourself as a brand. You have to establish something that you want to be known for, and then work at it again and again until that time that people go like, that guy that talks about this and this, or that guy that does this and this, then you know you've done it. Starting today, you have to think of yourself as a brand. You do not belong to any company for life. You are not defined by your job title, and you're not confined by your job description. Going forward now, it has become clear to me more and more that there is nothing more powerful than a personal brand. So the moment you have this personal brand that people can relate to and people accept you in that area, then they'll want to associate with you. So it can open doors for you more than any other character trait or talent. People trust you more. So when there's an established brand that is known for something, people go like, if this product is coming from that particular brand, then I know it is good. So you come across as a very trusted individual and people are willing to do business with you. Immediately, you differentiate yourself from your competition. You're immediately recognizable, and that will give you a competing edge with your competition, because now people go like, you want a lawyer? I know a very good lawyer and his name is so-and-so. You have a much higher perceived value. When you think about Facebook, for example, immediately think about the CEO. When you picture an Apple product, you think about Steve Jobs. When you think about Microsoft, the operating system, you think about Bill Gates. So when your brand is known, when your personal brand is very strong, then your value quadruples. And there's a way Jay-Z put it in one of his songs. He said, I'm not a businessman, I'm a business man. And that is the importance of personal branding. So in today's video, I've talked about personal branding and why it is important. Perhaps in a subsequent video, I'll be talking about how to develop your personal brand, how to go about it, and how to ensure that in time it's something that becomes valuable, it's something that becomes known, so that you are known for that which you want to be known for. So if this video provided you with a bit of value, give it a thumbs up. Also remember to subscribe to the channel if you've not subscribed to the channel yet. Also share the video with someone if you feel inclined to. And until next time, be the best version of yourself, and I'll be seeing you on the next.